wherever you're at, just get yourself set up in a tabletop position, and we'll go ahead and get started into it. So tabletop position, one of my favorite positions, because there's a lot of progressions that kind of go from here, and then you can even take it to a half kneeling, get the hips and so on and so forth. So for us, we're going to start in tabletop position. We're going to start with the cat and cow. So as I cave my chest in, I want to push into the mat, and I want to stretch the floor apart, try and stretch my knees away from each other to get a little bit more glute activation here. All right, so as I take my exhale, I'm going to tuck my chin, tuck my pelvis under, and then inhale, open up that heart, pull the chin up, throw my tailbone up. So let's start with cat and cow, just to wake up the breath, wake up that mid-back, wake up that chest. Deep inhale as I open up my heart. Exhale as I round my back up. You can even turn that neck a little bit, ear to shoulder. Just really start to open up those lungs. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. 3, 2, let's do one more. Perfect. You can flatten. Sorry, Nick. So sitting back in the child's pose position, you can either flatten the feet out or tuck the toes. But I want to take deep inhale to fill up my belly. And then exhale, let the chest just collapse and drop. Inhale. Exhale. Last one, deep inhale. Exhale. Perfect. Walking my hands over, so I'm going to face the camera, but walking my hands over, find the stretch on the opposite side, and just pull your hips back behind you as you reach 45 degrees out, looking for a good stretch, and bring that ear into your shoulder. You can open up your palm. Bring it back in, and then let's go ahead and switch up. So keeping my hips to my heels, reaching over 45 degrees, my left hand is gonna reach a little bit further than my right, and then drop into the ear. Just keep exhaling into it. Uh-oh, what's happening here with the Facebook? Uh-oh, let's see. Okay, there we go. Hope you guys can see me. So just taking it out. Now let's switch. I'm gonna reach and switch. Dropping. Reach my hand all the way out. Reach the other hand further. Blade my hand, press it into the mat, and then drop the shoulder. Inhale, as I switch, exhale. As I drop, inhale, reach, switch, exhale. Inhale, coming up, exhale, dropping. Last two, inhale, switch, last one. Perfect, perfect. All right, next one. So we got a nice good stretch there. Let's kind of keep going with the shoulders. I'm gonna pull my elbow up, and then just thread it through. Reach as far as I can, just drop my shoulder, pressing my hand into the mat, and just keep going. Open up, pull the elbow. You can even reach, and then thread it through. Inhale, push into the mat with the opposite hand. Drop the hips, drop the shoulder. On the exhale, inhale up. Exhale, drop. Inhale up, exhale, drop. Last two, inhale up, exhale, drop. Last one, inhale, exhale. Perfect, go ahead and switch, reset. Tabletop position, go ahead and pull that elbow up, and then thread it through. Exhale into it, inhale up. Exhale, thread it through. Inhale. Exhale. Pull that elbow, reach to the sky on the inhale. Thread it through on the exhale. Keep it going, last three. Two. Last one. Perfect, perfect. All right, let's go ahead and bring that left foot next to my left palm. All right, I'm gonna bring that left hand on top of my foot, and I can open up my base with my knee a little bit to find a little more base of support, and then I can even plant this here. So I'm gonna come out with my knee. I can even do the wiggle test, see where I'm at with my hips, and then come forward, inward, and around. So I'm gonna go all the way around with my knee. Imagine my knee is trying to hit north, south, east, and west, but I'm gonna pass through all of those points. Slow and controlled. Deep inhale, deep exhale, into those tension areas, any target spots, any stretching, stiffness that you might be feeling in the hips, and then go ahead and change direction. Breathing into the hips, deep inhale, deep exhale, deep inhale, deep exhale. Three, two, and one. Go ahead and switch it up. Other side. Foot next to the palm, hand on top of the foot. Go ahead and go out first, as far out as you can, and then forward. Just taking it all the way around. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Push that knee as far out and around as you can. Again, trying to hit all four points. North, south, east, west. Breathing into those hips. Nice, good knee circles. Keep that posture, keep that chest proud. Try not to round your back up. Keep the shoulders down and back. Go ahead and change directions. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Push that knee all the way around. Really trying to wake up those hips. See where you're at for the day. Three, two, and one. Perfect, perfect. All right, let's go ahead and bring it back to that other leg. Except now I'm gonna shoot my legs straight up. All right, so I'm gonna rock on this one. I'm rocking forward over my wrist. So go ahead and spread those fingers, plant them into the mat, push into the mat, and then inhale over the wrist to find a stretch there. And then exhale, sitting back on the heel, looking for a stretch right into the inner thighs there. Inhale, exhale. If you can get a side view, I'm coming over the wrist, push my hips forward, and then sit back on my heel. Inhale forward, exhale. At your own pace, inhale forward, exhale. I want to drive with my hips, so drive my hips forward, and then sit back. Let's do two more. Inhale, exhale, last one. Inhale, exhale. All right, go ahead and switch. Same thing, other side. Deep inhale, over the wrist. Exhale, back on the heel. Switch my view up again here. Inhale and exhale. Looking for a nice, good stretch on the exhale. Breathe into those knees, breathe into that groin area. All the muscle tissue that connects from my glutes and my hips down to my knees, into my ankles. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Last two movements here. Inhale over. Exhale, sitting back. Perfect, perfect. All right, real quick, just to kind of loosen up, we're gonna go belly down for some scorpions. So these are probably one of my favorite drills to do. I'm gonna go both arms out on this one just to keep it simple. Whichever way I'm facing, that's the leg, I'm gonna bend. So if I'm facing to my left, I'm gonna bring my heel to my butt, so I flex my hamstring, I pull my toes in, I'm gonna take an inhale as I pull up and over to touch the mat with my foot, and then I exhale. Spend a breath here, and then inhale, bring it back. Keep your core engaged. Exhale, drop. Now I'm gonna switch. Inhale. Exhale, drop the foot. So I'm inhaling during that transition. Inhale over. Exhale, drop. Inhale over. Exhale, drop. Keep it going. Inhale. Exhale. If you want to, you can either reach, so you can reach back behind you. And just the more you get fluid with it, the more you can start to speed up the pace, but with full control. Slow is smooth, and smooth is fast. Slow is smooth, and smooth is fast. Last two. Looking over that shoulder. Try not to shrug. Let's go, last one. Perfect, perfect. All right, let me turn to the side. We'll do a couple spinal rolls. So now my hands were out. I'm gonna bring them in. I'm gonna go ahead and push up for an upward dog. Find that stretch of the low back. Engage those glutes. Keep that core active. Looking up. Get a couple neck circles. Look over that left and right shoulder. Just kind of see where you're at. And then I'm gonna tuck my chin. Take an inhale as I push back. Really round my back up. Exhale. Back on the heels. Settle into that position. And then I'm gonna pull my pelvis underneath. So as I pull forward, I'm pulling my pelvis underneath my body to round my back up. So inhale forward. Keeping my chin tucked until I reach the top. Exhale. Tuck the chin, inhale, push back. Exhale. Sitting back on the heels. You can flatten out the feet if you want to. Let's do two more, inhale. Exhale, inhale, and exhale. Perfect, perfect. All right, so let me change the view here. All right, for this one, we're gonna get hip mobility here. So I'm gonna drive my knees to the opposite side. So if my right knee, I'm gonna drive it in, but I don't want my hands to come up off the mat. So I'm gonna elevate my knees, and all I'm gonna do is switch and drop my hip. I wanna be able to push into the mat so I don't round myself out. So pushing, posturing up, see where that stretch is at, and bring it back in, and then switch. Drop the shoulders, keep that chest proud. And just kinda, you can keep your knees down if you like, and all I have to do is bring my hip in. All right, just switching off. Going left to right. Exhale as I drop the hip and really find a stretch to the low back, even into the thoracic spine. So I'm looking for a rotation as my hips are facing the other direction. Just feel it out as slow as you need to. Taking your time, keep the chest proud, drop the shoulders. Really locking myself into that position, but I want to breathe into it. So if I were to do a side view, just do a couple more, guys. Posture up, bringing it back. Posture up, bring it back. If you notice, this foot is flat. All right, three. Two. Perfect, perfect. All right, next one, next drill. Let's do it from this side here. Left foot, back up. I wanna shoot my hips forward. So as I drive my hips forward, posture now. So I want this back leg. I want a nice, good stretch. So tucking that pelvis underneath, my hands are gonna come on the inside. Flatten my back out, and then that's it. So driving through the hips, I'm hinging, bringing my hands back down. So that's all we're doing. Inhale, up. Exhale, into that stretch on that bottom leg. Inhale down, exhale, planting my hands on the mat. Drop the shoulders, really lengthen that spine up. Inhale, exhale into the hip. Inhale, back down. Exhale. Perfect. At your own pace, just moving with your breath. Exhale at the top. Inhale, transition back down. Exhale. With my hands on the mat. So at your own pace, moving with your breath. Keep it going. There's a proud chest at the top. And a real proud chest at the bottom too. Don't forget that shoulder drop. Lengthen, reach the head away from the shoulders. Drive those hips forward. Really find that stretch on the front of the thighs there. Let's do one more, one more. Inhale. Bringing it back down. All right, switch it up. Drive the hips forward. Posture up. See where those hips are at. Really engage that glute. And then drop. Inhale. Up. At your own pace. Just keep switching off. Keep it going. Breathe into those hips. What's going on here? Something's going on with the Facebook here. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Keep it going. Let's do a few more. Really drive those hips forward. Really get that exhale into those hips there. All right. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Perfect, perfect. All right. So let's go ahead and I'm going to bring my hips all the way back behind me for that downward dog position. So if I were to set my toes under, I'm gonna push back, settle into that position, see where I'm at. Bend the knees slightly, drive my tailbone to the sky, push into the mat, really trying to push myself away, so lock those arms out. See if I can flex those triceps even. Keeping my shoulder blades packed down. Let's go ahead and come up to a plank position. Push myself into the mat, and then just coming back. Pushing all the way back behind me and up. Try not to look forward. Actually, you can if you want. But let's kind of see where my neck is at. I can look underneath the shoulders. Active glutes, active core. Trunk nice and stable, I'm pushing into the mat. Try not to sag or be too high. Drop the hips nice and a full plank. Pushing back. So that's all we're doing. We're just gonna come into a plank position and then downward dog. Push, push, push. See if I can make more room by getting a little bit more stretch to those hamstrings. Really driving into the ground. So inhale. Exhale, settle in. Active glutes. And then exhale. Pushing back. 5, 4. 3, 2. And finish out one more. Drop the knees, sit back on the heels, and relax. You can even bring those hands back behind you, dropping your forehead. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Really fill up that belly. Man, Facebook's just not having it, huh? A couple more breaths there and downward dog, guys. Take your time, take your time. All right, so now we're gonna open up the hips in that same downward dog position. So if I were to sit all the way back on the heels, tuck my toes under, reach my hands all the way out, I'm gonna drive my hips up. I'm gonna go
like our scorpion, this is an extended scorpion. So heel to butt, pull my hip up and over. Really find that nice little stretch. And then bring it back. So really I'm just gonna bring my knee in and then drive. All right, so heel to butt on the other side. Open up those hips. Drive the knee forward into that plank position. And then come back, settle in, reset. Reset after every rep. Still pushing into my hands. Still flexing that hamstring. And then drive that knee forward. And then reset. So at your own pace, take your time. Really settle into those end ranges. See how far I can open up. Drive the knee forward. And back. Exhale to any stiffness, any stretching. All right, let's do one more, last one. All right, so now I'm just gonna bring my knee behind my wrist, almost bringing it in for that pigeon pose. So I'll change my view here. Just kind of allow your hips, allow the weight to drop into your hips. You can push that opposite leg back. So you try and extend it out. Settle into that pigeon pose. Just settle in to those hips. You can stay on your hands if you like. Find that perfect stretch for you. You can come to the elbows. Or if you really have the flexibility, if you really have if you're able to, you can even reach all the way out. You can bring your forehead down to the mat if you like. And we're just taking some active deep breaths here. So deep inhale. Deep exhale. Deep inhale, deep exhale. All right, one more deep breath. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. Bringing that hand back in. Tucking the toes under on that back leg. Go ahead and push back to the downward dog. Pedal those knees a little bit. And then same thing on the other side. I'm gonna open up my hips. Drive my knee through. Extend that back leg all the way out. Slowly start to work your way down. Allow the weight, allow gravity to kind of push those hips down. You can even activate that back glute. Drop in the elbows. Relax. Continue that breathing. Deep inhale, deep exhale. More breaths. Finish out one more. And relax. Alright. So from right here, all I'm going to do is just sit on that hip. I'm going to bring that other knee in. So the knee comes to my other knee. So there's two positions here. There's actually a difference between the 90-90 position where I have 90 degrees on my front leg, 90 degrees on my back leg, or I can pull it in for a shin box. I can pull my ankles in for a shin box. Today we are gonna use the 90-90, so come out 90 degrees, you know, kind of open up here so you guys can see. 90, I think about half of a swastika. All right, knee forward. I'm gonna keep my heels digging into the mat. So my heels are gonna dig into the mat, try and posture up, and I'm gonna keep my toes pulled in. So as I plant my hands back behind me, I wanna push myself forward to really open up and drop to the other side. So I'm windshield wiping my knees. I'm switching off from this 90-90 position, trying to stay as tall as possible, keeping my chest proud, pulling my toes in. Make your adjustments. Check yourself, get nice and tall. Inhale as I transition. Exhale as I drop. Over the shoulder. Exhale as I drop. the knees. All right, let's do one more. We'll switch it up a little bit. All right, so now pull the knees in, or pull the ankles in, pull my feet in. Now we're gonna do shin box switches. So now you can keep the feet flat. Keeping my feet flat, I'm just gonna switch up. So this should be a little bit smoother than if I had my 90-90 position. So slightly different feel. Still looking over the shoulder, looking for that nice little trunk twist to look over. Nice and fluid. I like to grab my elbow. Just keep switching off. Exhale as I twist. Inhale over. Exhale as I twist. Overhead, drive my hips forward and out. Keep my knees and my shins and my feet down. Nice, good stretch. Drive that pinky up and out to that back wall, back corner of the wall. Reaching up and back, plant that hand, push into the mat. Switch it up. Keep it going. Exhale as I reach. Shins to pull myself forward. So as I exhale, cave my chest in. Inhale at the top. Seconds. exhale. Inhale for 3. Exhale for 7. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale for 3. Exhale for 7. Shake it off. Neck circles. Good job, guys. That's it. If you're coming to jiu-jitsu, hurry up. We'll get you guys going. That was a quick 30 minutes, I believe. Yeah, a little over 30 minutes. Some ground-based mobility today. I'll introduce a little bit more ground-based mobility work. So we usually start with standing, but it's also awesome to connect back to the ground. So I'll be kind of introducing more techniques for some ground-based movements. And of course, always gotta breathe. Always gotta finish out with the breathing. Love you guys. Appreciate it. We'll see you in just a few. Let me know what you need. Of course, send out your request. Love you guys. Peace.